Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to take a look at the stomata found on the surface of plant leaves under the microscope. The first type of leaf we are looking at is that of the pea plant, as an example of what stomata look like in dicotyledon plants. Stomata are mostly found on the bottom surface of the leaf, so this sample we are looking at is a peel of the outer layer of epidermal cells from the bottom surface of the leaf. Here on the lowest magnification, you can see a whole bunch of small oval-shaped structures on the surface of the leaf. These are where the stomata are. As you can see, there are a lot of them. Now if we go to a higher magnification, you can see them more clearly. What we are seeing mostly are the two guard cells that surround the stoma. The stoma is the pore found between these two guard cells. These two guard cells are what we call kidney-shaped. We can also see that the stoma, or pore between these two guard cells, is open. In addition to the specialized guard cells and the stoma, we can see the layer of irregular epidermal cells that cover the surface of the leaf. These guard cells function in controlling whether the stomatal pores are open or closed. When the guard cells are flaccid, the stomatal pore is closed and CO2 cannot enter into the leaf. When the guard cells are turgid, the stomata pore is open and allows CO2 to enter and diffuse into the cells to be used in the process of photosynthesis. How does this work? Guard cells sense and respond to a variety of external factors to the plant, including temperature and relative humidity. But the main external factor these guard cells react to is light, both the intensity and quality of light. In response to external factors that are in favor of stomatal opening, such as good light levels during daytime, a series of reactions occur within the cell that cause potassium molecules to be taken into the guard cell. This increases the potassium solute concentration in relation to the water concentration inside the guard cells, decreasing the osmotic potential, and as a result, water also moves into the guard cells. As this water moves into the guard cells, the turgor pressure within the cell increases, as well as the cell volume, which causes the cells to swell and the stomatal pore to open. When the conditions are not favorable for the stoma to be open, such as low light intensity during the night or low water levels in the soil, another series of reactions occur that stop more potassium entering the cell and the amount of potassium drops, as does the water potential and the cells become flaccid, which causes the stomatal pore to be closed. In dicotyledons such as this pea plant, we have seen that the guard cells are kidney-shaped. But what about the guard cells in monocotyledon plants? If we take a look at this non-grass monocotyledon, again we can see a whole bunch of oval-shaped structures, which are again the guard cells that surround the stomatal opening. Unlike in the dicotyledon leaf surface, the epidermal cells in monocots are more regular and rectangular in shape. If we go up to a higher magnification, we can see that although they are slightly different to those seen in the pea plant, the guard cells still have a kidney shape. These kidney-shaped guard cells surrounding the stomatal pores are the typical shape found in dicotyledon plants and many monocots, but some monocots, especially in the grasses, have a different shape. If we now look at the surface of a blade of grass, we can see here the guard cells surrounding the pore are more elongated with bulbous ends, giving a dumbbell-like appearance. The stomatal pore itself is more like a long slit between these elongated guard cells. In these plants, the guard cells have the help of subsidiary cells to help control the opening of the stomatal pores. The subsidiary cells flank the guard cells and are actually differentiated epidermal cells. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.